I do need to get to the hook. There is one thing that makes this special and something that I think the city, this town, no one's ever seen something like this before. And if you would just do me the honor of clicking on the, if you look at your email and pull it up right there on that screen, I got a link right there on the subject line. You just click that. It's going to take you to a page, a YouTube page, 22 seconds. Just watch that and it'll give you the answer you're looking for right now.
I have it right here.
All right, pull it right up and get back to me after. Talawanda. First of all, you got to call up the you got to do a few things for me. I've been packing up these boxes all morning. I need you to do one thing for me right here.
So, what do you think?
You're an asshole.
Why would you say that to me?
You think you can just go gallivanting around the world pretending to be a fucking rock star?
That's honestly disgusting. I didn't invite you to this party.
I can't believe you showed up here.
Stop. You're acting like you don't even want me here.
Yeah,
like,
I honestly don't want you here. That's insulting. Do you know who I am? I get more in allowance than you'll make in your entire life.
Please, baby.
This make me look like a plebeian.
Do you know who my father is?
I don't give a fuck about your dad.
That's insulting.
Don't even tell me that bullshit. Seriously, your daddy knows who I am, and you do too, so don't give me that bullshit.
If my dad knew what we were doing.
Look, your father knows I'm
smart.
He
could snap you in half, okay?
Don't give me that bullshit. So,
just watch your back, okay?
Why would you say all that, really?
Are you kidding me? You're not friends with us anymore.
So? It's cool. It's really cool. Look, all I'm saying is this, really. And I came for you. You want to be here.
You're an asshole.
You want to be here.
Right? I'm not forgiving you. This isn't an easy out for you. I don't want you to think that. I'm not like your little whore or whatever.
No, you're not my whore. You're just my bitch. I'm taking a tour with me. You want to come? You got all that money, whatever. I have my money. I'm taking a tour. It's going to be cool. I'll take you to Europe. You can have all that wine that you've been dreaming about.
I have to tell you something.
What's up?
I know this is really random. I applied to art school at Sarah Lawrence, and I got in.
So what are you saying to me? That you're going to go? No, you're not going to go.
Yeah, I'm going
to
go.
No, you're not. Don't do this shit to me. I'm serious. No, you're not going. You're not going. You're not going. I'm serious. You're not going. Don't even fucking cry. I'm serious.
You have to go.
No, you don't. Think about the life that we can live. I mean, we've always talked about it.
I have to go.
No.
I have to go. I'm sorry.
Look, okay. All right. When it's all said and done, yes, music is my life. But you know where you stand with me. You remember? You remember? Didn't you remember how we were? You remember sophomore year? I played that song for you.
I'm trying to do something with my life.
But this is Europe.
This is what you're telling me to do all the time. You're telling me to just, you know, be above my father, be better than that. And I'm trying to. But and now I've done something and now you don't want me to do it. My dad doesn't know that I got it.
So you're going to tell him?
No, I can't tell him.
Why?
Art?
So?
Art?
You already got your...
You think that my parents want me to go to art school? It's a joke to them. Art? Oh my god.
They've seen this stuff. They
would rather me sit on a couch all day being fed grapes than go to art school. Art is like dirt on the bottom of their shoe.
They appreciate
it. It's like
art.
Mice in their walls, you know? They just see it as trash.
Alright,
they
look.
See it. No, but this is the problem. He can't know.
Look.
He cannot know.
All I'm saying, you're so fucking concerned about your dad and all this shit, but this is what I need to figure out. I need to figure out either you're coming with me, which I know you fucking want to come with me because you want this. I want you too. So, either you're gonna have to fucking choose to stay in New York and do the whole art thing, or you can go to fucking Europe with me and tour, and you can do your art. And like in Europe, it's more progressive. What do you say? Please, don't. Why am I fucking saying please? Sure, I'm going on tours, but when I'm on tour, I miss you. I think about you so much,
yeah.
Baby. You know this.
Mm-hmm.
So don't make it seem as if I'm not, like, even...
You can't just say it like, oh, I think of you. Like,
I do.
This fucked up, man. Like, you,
what do you mean?
You don't care. You don't call me when I, like, try to talk to you. You don't care. You don't even ask me how the fuck I am ever.
No, we haven't really talked in a long time, but you can't deny that. But I don't think I've changed that much. That's why I'm here. I brought you in here for reasons. I'm serious.
Really? Because you think like one conversation is just gonna like fucking change everything that you've done?
No, I just want you to see that I'm still. We still fuck each other.
You change. You are the one that changed this. Who you are now is not who I started with. This isn't my responsibility to change with you that way. I can't, that's not fair.
Warren, I'm still that guy 4 years ago. I haven't changed. I mean, yeah. Because you give me the cold fucking shoulder. Tonight,
do you ever ask me why I do that?
Do you know how you were tonight? Do you know how you were tonight? I was staring at you and you turn your fucking head as if we haven't had history.
Because you disgust me right now.
How do I fucking disgust you, Sam? Seriously.
You want to know, finally, after all these fucking years, you want to know?
Yeah, tell me how the fuck
because
do I
you,
disgust you?
Because you are living this lonely little fucking dream of yours, and you've let everybody
who loved you so much, you let them go.
Sam, I've never let you go.
Yes, you
don't
did.
Say
yes,
that
you
shit.
Did.
Do not. No. Really? No. Yes, really. Don't say that shit to me. I've never let you go.
Then why now, after all this time? After how many cocktails are you able to even fucking talk to me?
It's not
about
the fucking cocktail, Sam. It's because we're fucking graduating. And for me...
And
why did you graduate? How many classes did you actually fucking attend? That doesn't even matter.
You ride the fucking ride. That's all you do.
Sam, just shut up for a second, please, alright? What I'm trying to tell you is that that shit does not even matter about... Oh, you know, like what's next or any of that bullshit. The fact is that I am where I fucking where I fucking am.
And you should be there, and I should
be not there. That's not it. That's not what I want. What the reason I brought you in this room is because I really wanted to let you know that I can't do this without you. I'm serious.
You've done it without me.
Yes, but I don't know what the fuck is next.
You're the star.
I don't know what's next, Sam. I don't know. My records, it doesn't have to fucking sell. You understand what I'm saying? I do not know what is next.
Okay.
But I need you.
Why?
Because...
Okay, look at us in 5 years. Look at us in 5 years, 4 years, 2 years. I'm on your little stinky-ass bus with your little band, your little groupies. What am I doing? What am I doing? Am I sitting there? Am I doing nothing? Am I saying, oh yeah, I'm dating that guy because I've dated him from fucking college and we should be together because we love each other so much.
Am I doing that? No, I can't do that. You're painting like some fucking like stereotype of what?
I'm not.
The music business is.
What do you
it
want
doesn't
me to
have
do?
To be like
you're
that.
You're gonna be on
real.
Tour every night for years. What am I supposed to do?
All I'm saying is basically this, just give me fucking time to like do this music thing.
I've given you time, I've given you everything, you've given me nothing, you give me no appreciation, you've given me nothing.
What are you talking
nothing.
About? I give you no appreciation.
You never
say thanks for
listening to your shit. You never say thanks for helping me out on my project. You never say thank you for getting my notes from under
the bus.
You never ever
do anything
like that for
me. I give you, okay, I'm going to tell you now, thank you so much for taking the fucking notes for me. I fucking appreciate it. Thank you so much. But what it boils down to, babe, is that I fucking love you. That's it. I'm serious. And I need you to know that. I love you so fucking much. I think about you all the fucking time. The songs that I've written, that song I wrote, you know what I'm saying? Like, everyone is fucking dancing to about that girl with the pretty brown eyes. It's fucking you. It's you. Babe, listen, look at me for a second. You know, you really know that I love you. So I don't want you to feel like, okay, how am I gonna fit in fucking his world or any of that bullshit, because it doesn't matter, because I'm being honest with you. You are my world. This music shit, it is what it is. It came because you fucking helped me with this. I've said it. I've told everyone that I've met, I was like, yeah, I'm in college and there's this girl I used to date, Sam, and she's the one who wrote it, and she sent it to the producer. They liked it and stuff like that, and then shit started happening. I'm always giving you the fucking credit. Don't do that, seriously. I just need you to trust me right now.
I'm done.
What do you mean you're done?
I'm done with this. I just can't.
Why do you have reservations about this? Because
you don't even know. You don't even know me anymore. You don't. This whole conversation is about you. It's about how I need to change for you again, and how I need to be the person for you again. When am I gonna? It's just gonna be the same thing over and over again, and I.
Baby,
I don't have energy for that. I have goals of my own. I have things that I want to do, and I'm done. I'm done.
Look. No, don't say that, please. I know you don't mean any of that shit, because it's not about me.
I do.
Why do you think it's about me? What?
Because it is. It is. And you need to go do your thing. And I need to go do my thing, and you know, maybe years and years and years from now we can cross paths and see them, but not today.
No, I'm not gonna do that. I'm not one of those guys who you're gonna tell, like, okay, well, you know, maybe 5 years
from now, if you cross my path and if you change your career or any of that bullshit, you're making it seem as if people in the music business, they're not even fucking married. Listen, you know who the fuck I am. We've been through the same fucking middle school.
And we've been through this conversation too many times. And I'm really, really tired of it. Aren't you tired of it?
No, because I think it's fucking worth it. You still don't get it. You don't get that.
You can't, just no. Because you say that right now, just because we're having this conversation right now, and you've said it because we've had this conversation before, and you've said it in this conversation, just because you say it that one time doesn't mean it's real. Doesn't mean it happens every day. Doesn't mean you look at me every day, and it's new, and it's fresh, and it's brilliant, and it's
love. I don't,
you
yes,
don't.
Yes, you're
you
right,
do
you're
that.
Right.
I don't. Deserve that.
Yes, that's what I'm asking for. What I'm basically saying is that if you come with me, if you come with me on tour just for like, just for a fucking year, you don't have to go to graduate school.
Not,
you don't have
to
think about that shit. I already have the money.
You want me to give
I have
up everything
money.
That I do? Everything.
Sam, no one is. I'm not talking about your smarts. I know that you're smart. Everybody outside, they know that you're smart. You took the notes. Yes, we know. But all I'm saying is that right now my career is fucking, it's going. I can't stop this, and I'm not trying to stop it. I can do this for both of us. So all I'm asking you is just give me a fucking year. Just come on tour with me, please.
No.
All right? Just come on tour with me, please. Just don't say no. Just come on tour with me, please.
You guys are doing great. Everyone else doesn't know where they're going, their next dime is, their next rent check. With me, you have security and love. How can you pass that up?
Baby, all right. I'm already there. Everyone else, they're trying to figure their ish out, what's next for them or whatever. You don't have to worry about shit. I already have. Dude, there's a limo outside waiting. You know what I'm saying? Like, I can take you to wherever.
That doesn't matter to me.
I know it doesn't matter. That's not what I'm saying. Basically, all I'm trying to say is that you don't have to feel, like, insecure as if I'm not going to take care of you. I will.
I don't feel... You're not even listening. I don't feel insecure.
So what?
I don't feel like you... I'm not going to be taken care of. I don't have finances. That I'm not going to be, like, wealthy. I don't care about that shit.
So why can't you just like, hold off of school for a year and just...
Because you're asking me to hold off school for a year. You're asking me to put my fucking life on hold again. I'm not going to do that. You...
I don't know.
Are not worth it anymore.
Why can you... Why would you even say that to me, really? That I'm not worth it anymore?
Because you're...
What does that mean?
Because you're asking me to put down. I just graduated college.
I graduated with you, Sam. What
no,
the
you
fuck?
Didn't. Where were you? Where in the whole time? Because you have a fucking diploma doesn't mean you were with me.
I was. It doesn't matter if I was touring or whatever the fuck it is. I turned my
it
fucking assignments
matter.
In.
It does matter.
I took classes online.
Yep.
All right.
And every one of your professors is okay with you missing their classes because of who you are, where you're going, what you
Dude,
want. And you don't feel a thing about that.
No, I did the work.
No, you didn't.
I did the work. Don't tell me I didn't do the work. I fucking did the work. I did it online. Yeah, sure.
Your,
I wasn't
your
in class.
Your college experience
but I did
is a joke. You have a degree because you can sing. And you can make a career. And if a professor can say, oh, well, I used to teach that young man before he became a big superstar, then yeah, you're gonna ride that.
Wow. Wow.
Yeah, wow. Truth fucking hurts, doesn't it?
Wow. Sam.
And you want me to put everything that I worked so goddamn hard on, so goddamn hard on.
Wow.
You want me to put that aside so I can go sit in your bus and be part of your little dream.
Fuck you. I mean, like, all this bullshit you're talking about as if... You know, Sam, I'm a fucking hard worker.
I believe right? that for
no,
yourself.
No,
you're
no,
a really
no,
hard worker.
No, no,
fine.
Not for
you're
myself.
You're amazing. You're a godsend. You're unbelievable.
Can I talk? Can
really.
I talk? May I speak, please?
Freely. Go
Thank
on.
You. For you to fucking tell me that, oh, you know, your college experience was just a fucking joke. You sang your way through college.
Mm-hmm.
That's bullshit, Sam. I got a fucking scholarship for my academics.
When we
Let
were
us
in high
not
school,
forget.
You got a scholarship for
Okay,
it.
Fine. Let
That's
us not
four
forget.
Years ago.
Let us not forget. And so I'm working my ish, alright? I'm working hard. I'm working hard taking online classes, alright? I did that shit. Yes, you took some notes for me. Thank you so much. But what the fuck?
Yes, music is my life.
But you know where you stand with me. You remember? You remember? Didn't you remember how we were? You remember sophomore year? I played that song for you. You remember? It was really cool. Don't make me sing it.
I'm trying to do something. I'm trying to do something with my life.
But this is Europe.
This is what you're telling me to do all the time. You're telling me to just, you know, be above my father, be better than that. And I'm trying to. But and now I've done something and now you don't want me to do it?
I'm just saying, can't you do it in Europe?
What's that? What's his name? With the FBI? New York FBI? Alright, put him through. Put him through. Hello, Matt, hello? I can't hear, let me put you on. I got my problem here right now, speaker's on. Sorry, sir, may I help you? This is Mr. Lee. I don't have a lot of time, but I heard you're FBI. You're with the FBI. I'd like to accommodate you any way I can, but I don't have much time, so if you could cut to the chase, so to speak.
Well, Mr. Lee, this is Bo Bassard. I'm actually with the New York Attorney General's office, and I'm giving you a call in regards to some found footage you may have in your possession.
I suppose... Since I've been in this business a lot of years, and I'll admit, when this thing came in anonymously, you must know by now that it came in anonymous, and we still don't know who it came from. But yeah, this was some material that the best of us, the most professional among us, we still don't know what to make of it, heads or tails. And we were about to call you, I gotta tell you. We weren't trying to pull any funny stuff, but we just didn't know what we had.
Yeah, they're always about to call. Let's go back to the tape. You said it came anonymously. Did that come through the mail?
By Federal Express, sir.
And do you still have the envelope that it came in?
Yeah, absolutely, sir. I mean, we're not idiots. I mean, we are. We ain't from West Virginia or Louisiana. I'm just telling you, know, we get, even though I have a southern accent, I think some of this footage we
the
found
FBI,
out that one
however,
of the individuals
was
rejected from marriage proposal and
which
humiliated
apparently
by the fact
they
this
kept
woman
under seal and no one has seen that, not even NBC, Universal, Comcast, or CAA. To cover the damage, if you will, or spin this correctly, this is designed to give all profits to the families and victims. And this new footage, which has recently been sent to the DC office of the FBI, who's not even handling this, it's the New York office that's been handling this interrogation. But the TV series on the 21st of August has been released. The trailer for the graduation party, which is going to be the name of the series, was released. But here on the 21st of October, the shit has really hit the proverbial flat screen. I don't know what to do, what to say next, other than they're not dead and we're not sure why.
They have a right to their privacy. They have a right to their own lives.
Yeah, but you know, when you're at a party, there's nothing that's private. Huh? There is no privacy at parties.
Again, I think you may have a couple of civil suits from some parents that may contradict that. But that's not my concern, and that's not my jurisdiction. We will end with this. We want to have a follow-up interview with you. We want to set up, until this phone dies on her end, we are still tracking that down. We haven't got premiering, which, again, turns my stomach sick, but what, it's two Thursdays from now? I mean, at 8 or something?
Cross country trip thing? Did I ever do that? Because I've been saving, but
Do I ever do it? I'm not here to tell you your future. I'm not here to tell you what you should and shouldn't do. I'm here to tell you this, is that you are solely responsible for the way that you want to live your life. If you want to jump off a cliff in Hawaii, jump off a cliff in Hawaii. But know there's consequences if you hit a rock or if you don't. But you're prepared for both. But don't not do that because you're afraid of hitting the rock. Do it because you want to fall and you want to be free and you want to feel what that feels like. Because that is something, that is a gift. That is beautiful. That is joy. That is freedom. And you have that in you to do that.
Getting ready for this American debut. Well, there was something leaked to the press. It was a piece of footage, like an outtake, and it was all these kids at the party, and they were all talking different. And then at the end of this footage, they actually are talking about, the word movie comes up, like they're actors or something. They actually talk about making a movie. So you put that next to all this footage, and you realize that these kids aren't graduating from no college. These kids are actors, professional actors. That's why I was so damn convincing.
Something that triggers something. It doesn't matter what. But someone can say something that triggers an emotion, a response. No. And so just allow me to just finish. Just take a time out and just evaluate where she's coming from. Fact of the matter is that the negative energy is present. So as a group, what we need to do is factor it out.
Concentrate on her.
We don't want some people to feel, or her to feel, uncomfortable as if she's not wanted.
Okay. Listen, you're right.
No, just
right.
Please.
That was juicy.
You guys, just listen. No. Regardless if we don't have time for it, the fact is
we're making a movie. Whoever doesn't want to fucking make it,
no,
be here.
That attitude, yeah. That's what I'm talking about. That attitude
is... I don't want to concentrate on negative energy.
No one ever wanted to be upset.
I think it's logical. Yeah.
No one wants that.
Because I think it will aid us in the long run to work as... Thank you.
30, 20,